Hello my friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Kechi Bulia, I am beauty and fashion retoucher. I would like to share with you my retouching actions which I created myself. You might have seen them in all my workflow videos cause I always use them in my retouching process. And I am often asked in the comments on YouTube and Instagram to share these actions, especially you're interested in my dodge and burn axillary layers, the way I create and use them. You can download them right now by following the link below. And in this video there will be a short review of each action. I'll show you the best way to use them. Let's go! This is our starting point. You have opened Photoshop and you don't have my actions yet. You need to install them. I have the actions window in this place. You may have it in a different one or it may not be in your workspace at all. To find this window, you have to open the window tab, find the actions here and click on them. The actions window will appear on your screen, put it wherever you want. To load my actions, I click here on the four lines and choose load actions. You have to go into the folder where you have the downloaded file from the description and select it. You can see that these are the same actions that I already have. Let's go in order. The first action is frequency separation. In this technique, I divide the photo into two frequencies only, high and low. All the actions are started with this button. There appears a window where we can select the radius of the blur. And if I wanted to correct the lip contour here, I would choose radius 4. Then I click OK. And that's okay too. And you can already use frequency separation. Here is the low frequency, here is the high frequency. If you want to use this action twice, you need to rename the layers. So that when you create new ones, the names don't conflict like now and all the filters are applied correctly. For example, I just add 1 in the name. And then I create another frequency separation without any problems. It can also be renamed and you will be able to make an infinite numbers of separations. The next action is dodge and burn for retouching on curves. Retouching brackets means that axillary layers are created here. We have a blur layer, a folder with curves for lightening and darkening, and 3 adjustment layers. I start adjusting with contrast. That contrast, which is automatically set, is most often fine for the work. But if you don't see the spots well, you can increase it by moving the bottom point to the right. Then the exposure curve, I lower it or raise it until I see the spots I want. I like to start from forehead and at this exposure, the spots will show properly there. Press OK. You don't need to adjust the black and white layer. And now, on the bottom blur layer, we set the radius. I use this layer to remove the texture so I can see it and therefore can't mess it up. You can see by yourself how well the spots are visible now. For the forehead, I would set the radius 11. That's it, the axillary layers are set. Now I open the dodge and burn folder and can get to work. I need a brush, I usually set the flow to 3%. Choose completely soft and it must be white. To lighten the spot, I work on the mask of the dodge curve. And to darken it, I work on the mask of the burn curve. Dodge and burn is a very important skill for a professional retoucher. If you want to learn this technique in more depth, I invite you to my course. There, I will explain the sense behind dodge and burn, you will see how I edit photos more detailed and you will get free rolls to practice new skills right away. You can see the exact curriculum on my website, the link is in description. The next action, it's essentially the same except you do the dodge and burn not on curves but on a gray layer. I know that retouchers work differently, so I have both, curves and a gray layer. You can use whichever way you prefer. All the axillary layers are set up likewise. The only difference is that for the brush, I set the flow to 1%. For lightening and darkening, I only change the color of the brush to white and black, respectively. The colors in the palette are switched with the X hotkey. After you have finished working on the dodge and burn, you can either hide all the auxiliary layers or remove them altogether. You won't need them anymore. The following actions are also dodge and burn, but they're without auxiliary layers. They are called volume because I use them mainly to enhance the volume of the face. The action is also available in two versions, on curse and on a gray layer. The upcoming actions are no longer retouching techniques, but rather tricks for improving a photo. For example, the whites of eyes section removes stray tints and brightens the whites of the eyes. I also take a soft white brush, flow 100%, and select the desired area on the mask. It removes all the stray shades, and the red and yellow are only muted, so that the eyes are not completely colorless and lifeless. The effect is very gentle. But if you feel like the eyes are too brightened, you can go into the layer settings and lower the curve a bit. Or, on the contrary, raise the curve to lighten the whites even more. I also use this action on teeth. You can see that the teeth are not lifelessly white, but the stray shades are muted. I think it's a little light for the teeth. I'll bring the curve down. Mostly I needed to correct the color here. Next action, to make the iris shine. It's quite intense, and that's why I always reduce the opacity of the layer. I go over the iris with the brush, and sometimes over the pupil, if there are nice highlights. Try not to go out of borders. There is also shadow on the eyes from the upper eyelid and lashes, so you can gently remove the impact of the layer on top for more contrast. I'll set the opacity at this value. I like the way it looks. Next up is action skin toning. I honestly love it, it's as simple as possible, but it's a great way to tone the skin to give the face a healthy color. This method works especially well if your white balance is a little cool or if the skin tone is pale. You should definitely try this action too, I'm sure you will like it. Next is an action remove redness. I don't usually use it on face because the problem with redness of the skin is most often found on the hands and feet. The next action is contrast. It's set to 15% opacity right away because the effect is quite strong. But you can increase or decrease it if you want. That's the way I like to apply contrast, through the channel mixture. And the last action is sharp. Also, a fairly common way to add sharpness through the high pass filter. I usually set the radius to either 2 or less. You can apply the layer to the whole photo, or you can add a mask and use it only on the unsharpened areas of the skin. This action is not adding artificial noise, but sharpening natural texture. That's why the result looks natural. Double click on the high pass filter under the layer name and you can change the radius. This also works in the dodge and burn action on the auxiliary blur layer. You can always change all the auxiliary layers in the process. That's it, I have shown you all the actions. As a proof that I really use them, I'll show you my PSD file. First, I have layers with liquify and cleaning. Then I have the first frequency separation. I fixed makeup a bit on it. Dodge and burn for retouching. I work on curves. I remove the auxiliary layers in the end. Next comes another frequency separation. Here I just copied the layer with the high frequency. The teeth folder is renamed whites of eyes. You can see that the folders are the same, and I apply this action to both the teeth and the eyes. Iris layer. I manually adjusted the selective color myself. And the last layer is my action for adding contrast. You don't have to use all the actions in every photo. Use what you need in a particular moment. You have seen that I use my own actions all the time. And in fact, I don't need any others. I don't even have anything else installed. Everything I needed, I automated. The rest I do by hand. These actions are my foundation. I hope you will like them too. They will be useful for you, will help you to speed up your work and maybe even change your retouching process. Thank you for watching my video, and if you still have questions, leave them in the comments. Like and subscribe to my channel not to miss the next video. And on Instagram you can see my works and before after. The link is in description. Bye!